can I'm not, I'm not, I'm not. But I just cried out unto the Lord. I poured out my soul unto the Lord. And then I love what Eli told her. He said, Eli answered and said, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant thee thy petition that thou hast asked of him. And that's why it's important for you to have spiritual parents, because they're the one that speak over your life a release. And that's why you can't get none from God, because you got to connect to your spiritual parents so that you can be released into what God called you to. I know you think you're a wonder, and I know you think you can do it yourself, but ain't nothing like a spiritual father to validate who you are in God and release you into destiny. Look at somebody say, ain't nothing like it, ain't nothing like it. Because one thing about it, when you step out, you know you step out in your daddy's anointed. And that's why I got to slip away to Shiloh. And look at somebody and say, there's one thing when you have a Shiloh experience. Your worship change. Because the Bible says in verse 19, and they rose up in the morning early in worship before the Lord, and returned and came to the house of Ramah, and Elkanah knew him and his wife, and the Lord remembered her. And when you have a Shiloh experience, when you have a Shiloh experience, your worship will go to the next level, and the enemy can't agitate you. The enemy can't aggravate you during the time of worship, because I lift up my eyes to the hills, from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord that created the heavens and the earth. So I don't care what's going on around me. Come on, Peter. Peter stepped out on the water and began to walk to Jesus. And when the storms came, when the wind blew, he took his eyes off Jesus and put his eyes on the storm. But after you have a Shiloh experience, your eyes is on Jesus, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despised the shame, and now sits at the right hand of the Father. Look at somebody say, keep your eyes on Jesus. When you have a Shiloh experience, your worship changes. And the Bible says the Lord remembered her. In other words, when you have a Shiloh experience, you won't be barren any longer, because God got the clog out. You had a clog in your heart. There was something going on with the blood flow. The blood flow went right. Your heart wasn't pumping right. But that's one thing about when you go to Shiloh. God has a way of getting the clog out, so I don't have to hate any longer. I don't have to be hatred. I don't have to hate my sister. I don't have to talk about my sister. I don't have to be bitter anymore. I know. You've been through some bitter situations. But when you have an experience at Shiloh, there's something about that experience that the blood of Jesus started running warm in your veins. And he began to cover some things. He began to remove some things. He began to heal some things. So I don't have to do that any longer. But I can lift my hands up and say, God, I love you. God, I adore you. God, I magnify you. God, I lift you up. You're the God of my salvation. Because I slipped away to Shiloh. Come on in this place. Come on, I want every daughter to come around this altar with your hands up. You're going to slip away to Shiloh. I won't go through this no more. I'm not a shame. I'm in the eighth month now. The month of new beginnings. Come on, close in the altar. Because you're going to hold hands with your sister. And you're going to pray this thing out. We won't go through this. I would not go through the same thing that I went through for the last 5 years. I would not be hindered, but I will burn out. I will burn out the will of God concerning my life. In the name of Jesus, I'm going to reconnect back to this house.
Look at somebody say, I'm not crying anymore. I'm not crying. I'm not crying. I'm not crying. I'm not crying. I'm not crying in my flesh. I'm not crying in my flesh. I'm not crying in my flesh. Because I'm going to leave it on the altar once and for all. And I will not pick it back up. Come on. Come on. Come on. Those things that come to haunt you. Those things that torment you. I don't know what you've been through. Some have been through rape. Some have been through molestation. Some have been through divorce. Some have been through church hurt. Whatever your situation is, I want you to tap in right now and begin to cry out unto the Lord. Come on, even the leaders, you need to cry out too. Come on, I won't pick up pride no more. I will not pick it back up, but I will connect to my spiritual father. I will do the will of God concerning my life. I will do his will. Come on, men out there, put your hands this way. Begin to pray over God's women. Hold up a shire. Come on, cry out, daughters. We need some wailing women. Come on, cry out, cry out. I need to hear you cry out to the Lord. Come on, cry out. Come on, it's between you and God. It's between you and God. Come on. Come on, cry out. You know what it is. Come on, all that bitterness. Disobedience. Witchcraft. And that witchcraft means bitterness. Come on, you gonna come out of that witchcraft. Come on, cry out, cry out. Come on, cry out, cry out. You know you should be preaching, but instead you complaining. Come on, cry out to the Lord. You know you should be worshiping, but instead you've been a whore. Come on, cry out to the Lord. Come on, cry out, cry out.
Standing in shallow, standing.